Sairam children, welcome back to Social Studies Revision, Chapter Number 3, Continents and Oceans. Children, you have already learnt this chapter, right? Chapter Number 3. Today we are going to revise the chapter one more time. Now, view this picture. What is this person holding? What is there in his hand? Yes, it is a globe. What is a globe? A globe is a model of the earth. Yes, a model of the earth called a globe shows us the whole earth. We can rotate it to see different places. However, a globe is not big enough to show all the places in detail. So children, how can we solve this problem? Means, how can we see all the places in detail? This problem can be solved with the map. Yes, with the help of the map, we can see all the places in detail. Let us learn about map. Now children, view this picture. What is this? This is a map, right? Now children, tell me, what is a map? Yes, it is a kind of drawing, right? Something is drawn, no? On the screen you can see. Yes, drawing of a part or the whole of the earth is called a map. A map can be big or small. We can hang a map on a wall. We call it a wall map. Now children, what is an atlas? Yes, you have learned. View this picture, you can see a book, right? Yes, this is a book of small maps. An atlas is a collection of maps, right? You can find different types of maps in atlas. Children, just view this picture and try to recall, what is this picture showing? Yes, it is showing directions on a map. There are four main directions. Can you remember the names of four main directions? They are north, south, east, and west. And there are four sub-directions. What are the four sub-directions? Yes, direction between north and east is northeast. Direction between south and east is southeast. Direction between north and west. Yes, children, it is northwest, and direction between south and west is southwest. Now, if you stand facing a map, the top part of the map is north. The bottom is south. To your right is east, and to your left is west. You will see the direction north marked in most maps. These directions help us to locate places on a map. Now children, see this picture? Yes, you have learnt about it. Yes, this is a compass, right? A compass is used to find directions. Sailors use a compass to find their way while sailing. A compass looks like a watch. The needle of a compass always points to the north. Okay, this line is very important. The last line, the needle of a compass always points to the north. You can view the picture, you can see the needle. It is pointing north direction. Now, children, look carefully at the world map on the screen. You will find that some areas in the map are in blue color, while others are in brown. The blue areas show water bodies and the brown areas show land masses. A very large land mass is a continent. Follow, children? What is a continent? A very large land mass is called a continent. A very large body of water is called an ocean. So, what is an ocean? A very large body of water is called an ocean. Children, try to recall the names of the continents of the world. How many continents are there? Yes, children, there are 7 continents. Now, name the 7 continents. Which are the 7 continents? Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, and Australia. Now, which is the largest continent? This is very important. Which is the largest continent? Largest continent is Asia. Asia is the largest continent of the world. And which is the smallest continent of the world? Yes, it is Australia. Australia is the smallest continent of the world. Now, children, can you identify the name of the continent? Yes, which continent is this? This is Asia. This is a map of Asia. India is in Asia, right? Now, continents are further divided into smaller parts called countries. India is a country within Asia. Followed? India is a country within Asia. How many oceans are there? There are 5 oceans. Which are the 5 oceans? Yes, children. Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, Arctic Ocean. So, how many oceans are there? There are 5 oceans. Now, which is the largest ocean? Yes, children. Which is the largest ocean? The Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean. Followed? Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean. And which is the smallest ocean? Arctic Ocean is the smallest ocean. I have underlined it. Arctic Ocean is the smallest ocean. Oceans are very deep. What is an ocean bed? Ocean bed means floor of the ocean. The ocean floors are not plain or flat. Follow, children, they are not plain or flat. There are long mountain ranges. Long mountain ranges and trenches on the floor. Trenches means depression. See, I am circling it. Trenches on the floor. So, isn't it interesting? Yes, there are long mountains inside the ocean, right? Let us revise the important points of this chapter. A globe is a model of the earth. A map is a drawing of a part or the whole of the earth. There are four main directions: north, south, east, and west. A continent is a huge landmass on the earth. There are seven continents: Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia, and Antarctica. Asia is the largest continent and Australia is the smallest continent. An ocean is a very large water body. There are five oceans: Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. Now, Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean and Arctic Ocean is the smallest ocean. These are the following words that you have to remember: continent, a large landmass on the surface of the earth; ocean, a very large body of water; map, a drawing of the whole earth or a part of it; globe, a model of the earth; atlas, a book of maps; compass, an instrument used to find directions. The needle of a compass always points to the north. Children, let us learn to solve objectives. Now, how you have to solve objectives? You have to click the correct option. The smallest ocean in the world is, the options are given: option A, the Pacific Ocean; option B, the Arctic Ocean; and option C, the Atlantic Ocean. Now, which is the smallest ocean in the world? Yes, children, the Arctic Ocean is the smallest ocean, right? So B option is the correct option. So what you have to do? You have to click B option. Okay, you have to click B option. Now, I am ticking, I am just putting a tick mark, but in exam you have to click the option. Okay, what you have to do? You have to click the option. On the maps, water bodies are shown in green, yellow, blue. This is very easy, right? Water bodies are shown in which color, children? Yes, children, water bodies are shown in blue color, right? So which is the correct option? C is the correct option. So you have to click option C. Okay, now this question is little different. Click against the correct option to complete the following sentences. Now here you have to make a meaningful sentence. Followed? So you have to read all the options and then you have to find out the correct option so that the sentence becomes meaningful. Now, the first one, there are, now option A, five continents in the world; option B, seven continents in the world; option C, six continents in the world. Now, which is the correct option, children? How many continents actually are there? There are seven continents, right? So option B is the correct option. So you have to click option B. Now the next question. Continents are further divided into smaller parts called countries, smaller parts called drawings, smaller parts called places. Now, which is the correct option to make this sentence meaningful? Yes, A option, right? Smaller parts called countries. Continents are further divided into smaller parts called countries. So option A is the correct option. So you have to click option A. So this way we have to solve the objectives. Every time we have to click the correct option. Follow children, we have to click the correct option. Okay, so we have completed the revision of chapter 3. Read the textbook. All the questions will come from the textbook. So read the textbook thoroughly. This is very important. Followed? Okay. Thank you.